Greetings. As I was studying Sura 5:18 recently, I made another observation. Let's look back at Sura 5:18. And both the Jews and the Christians say, "We are the children of Allah and His loved ones. Say, why then does He punish you for your sins?" I've already covered this portion of the Sura in my previous video. "Nay, you are but human beings of those He has created. You are but human beings." In Muhammad's ignorance, he seems to think Christians think we are gods. Think about that. If you read Surah 5:73-75, Muhammad argues that Mary and Jesus are not gods. So, you know, Satan argued against the Trinity and Jesus' divinity. And Satan feels it necessary to argue against Christians and Jews being divine? Kinda makes you go, What does Satan know, and what is Satan afraid of, that he must argue man is not divine? Moving on. "Nay, you are but human beings of those He has created." Rather than hold this dismissive view of mankind, Prophet David revealed God has a much higher opinion and status of man. Psalms 8:4. "What is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou visitest him? Yet you have made him a little lower than God, and you crown him with glory and majesty." Evidently, Prophet David understood God's purpose is higher than Muhammad's derogatory opinion. Think about that. Muhammad cannot confirm a message by Prophet David that Muhammad knows nothing about. But perhaps this gives a glint and hint, a glimmer, a sliver of what Satan is afraid of. "Yet you have made him a little lower than God, and you crown him with glory and majesty." 1 Corinthians 6:3. "Know ye not that we shall judge angels? How much more things that pertain to this life?" Don't you know that we will judge angels? Maybe the fallen leader of the fallen angels has something real to fear. He forgives whom He wills, and He punishes whom He wills. Does that even register with you? Allah is random. He forgives whom He wills, and He punishes whom He wills. Talk about a completely untrustworthy soul. He forgives whom He wills, and He punishes whom He wills. You have no insight and no input whatsoever into this Allah character. You can suck carpet and eat salad 5 times a day, and carry all 5 pillars your whole life, and it means nothing. He forgives whom He wills, and He punishes whom He wills. Allah just doesn't happen to forgive you. So shut up and suck it up. Get over it. It's just not your day, or life, or eternity. Now that sounds a mite disrespectful to the Lord of the worlds, doesn't it? I assure you, I have nothing but awe-filled fear and trembling toward the real God of heaven and earth, Yahweh. I firmly believe God is the judge of all, and as our Maker, He makes vessels for honor, those who will become believers in His Son, and vessels of dishonor, all those who cling to and worship something above God. This includes Muslims who love Muhammad more than God and hold his pagan Allah above the God of Abraham. And if you cannot tell that Muhammad's pagan Allah is different than Almighty God, you have not stopped to think about the differences. If you fit that description, let this surah be your first awareness. Muhammad claims Allah forgives whom He wills, and Muhammad claims Allah punishes whom He wills. Not so the God of Abraham. unless you hold to some Christian sect that believes in predestination, which could be described as God saves whom he wills and God damns who he wills, who he created for the fires before they were born. I strongly encourage you Christian brothers who believe in Calvinism to seriously cogitate on the legalistic similarity to Satan's counterfeit religion, Islam. How does the God of Calvin differ from the Allah of Muhammad? And this is definitely going down a different train track than my rebuttal of Sura 5:18. And to Allah belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth, and all that is between them, and to him is the return. What is between the heavens and the earth? Really, this is the first I've ever heard of something between the heavens and the earth. Maybe this is an heretofore unrecognized nugget of Quranic scientific factored. So, see how much there is to learn wrong from Sura 5:18? 1. Jews and Christians have never claimed Allah as their father. 2. Muhammad stupidly tries to teach punishment by God is an evil to be avoided. 3. Muhammad argues against a false notion that Jews and Christians are confused about their own deity. 4. Muhammad admits that Allah is random and untrustworthy. 5. Muhammad mentions an unidentified aspect of the universe, the space between heaven and earth. Okay, I'll give Mo that freebie. He meant clouds. Yeah, that's it. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.